Hello, I'm Jack. Welcome to my channel, Practical Programming with Dr. Su. In this video series, you will learn everything you need to get started with WGPU graphics programming in Rust. In the last video, I provide an overview about Rust WGPU API. And so what you can do with this API. In this video, I will explain how to set up the development environment for building the WGPU applications. In this video series, we will use the following development tools. First is Visual Studio Code. And C++ build tools. This is required by the Rust. We will use Rust as our programming language, and we will use Cargo as the Rust package manager. To run WGPU applications on native devices, you also need to have a modern graphics card installed on your machine. Your graphics card also has a modern graphics backend, such as DirectX 12, Vulkan, Metal, depending on what operating system you are using. Here, I will use a desktop PC with Windows 10 to build WGPU applications in this video series. Since WGPU is a cross-platform API, so you can use any system you like to build your WGPU applications. I suppose you already installed Visual Studio Code on your machine. Next, we need to install C++ build tools. Open a web browser and search for C++ build tools from this link. Okay, here, the Microsoft C++ build tools. This is a standalone MSVC compiler, libraries, and scripts. So you can click this download build tool link to install these build tools on your machine. If you have installed Visual Studio on your machine, you may already have the C++ build tools. So you can open Visual Studio installer to check it. Make sure you select the following workload. Now let's open the installer. For example, we check the version 2019, so click the modify. Okay, make sure .NET desktop development, this workload checked. And also desktop development with C++, checked. And also universal Windows platform development, checked. These three workloads you need to install on your machine. Since new Rust project default to use Git, so you will also need to add the individual component. Click this individual component tab and search for the Git. You can install the Git Harbor extension for Visual Studio, or you can click this Git for Windows. So make sure these two individual components are installed. So you may not need all of these workloads, but it is likely that some dependency will arise where these workloads are required. So it is just simpler to select all these workloads. Okay, you have installed C++ build tool. Now you will need to install Rust from this web browser. Search for the install Rust. Here is install Rust. Click this link, which brings up the official Rust installation page. Here, the page automatically checks your operating system. You can see here, it looks like you are running Windows. So just click this link, download it. So we will use the Rust app installer to install the Rust. This installer will install Rust C, Cargo, Rust App, and other standard tools. So now I suppose you already installed this Rust on your machine. Now we can open a command prompt window to check the version of the Rust. Run the command Rust C version. You can see here's version 1.55.0. Now we can also check the cargo version. It also shows 1.55.0. If you see a version number presented on your screen, then it confirms that Rust was installed correctly. If you installed Rust app in the past, you can update it by running the following command, Rust app update to the latest version. Now we have finished Rust installation. Let's use cargo to create a new Rust project with the command cargo new wgpu02. Because this is an example program for our second video of this series. Okay, our project was created successfully. Now we cd into this new folder, cd. And then use code paired to open Visual Studio Code. Here is our Rust project inside Visual Studio Code. Here you need to install an extension called Rust Analyzer. So click this extension link, search for Rust. Here you have Rust. This is the official Rust extension. Here is Rust Analyzer. In my machine, I already installed this Rust Analyzer. You can use either the official Rust extension or Rust Analyzer. Both provide code highlight and intelligence for the Rust code. So I suppose you already installed one of them on your machine. Now we can check the Rust code. From src folder, you can see we have a main.rs file. This is Rust file. So click this file to open it. Here is the code in this file. Now let's run the application by pressing F5 key. If you are running your application under the debugger for the first time, you will get a dialog box saying cannot start debugging because no launch configuration has been provided. Click OK. This brings up another dialog. This says cargos.toml has been detected in this workspace. So would you like to generate launch configuration for its targets? Click Yes. So this is a launch JSON file is generated automatically. So you can close this file. Now we can press F5 key again. This time the program runs successfully. It gives the result "Hello World" printed on your screen. Next, we need to configure our WGPU project. For every Rust application, there is a cargo.toml file in the root directory. Now open this file and replace its content with the new code. In Rust, we usually call the packages as queries. In the dependency section, you can see here contains different queries. The queries listed in this dependency section will be used to create our WGPU applications. Here are some important queries. The first one is WGPU 0.12. This is the latest version of the WGPU package. Another important one is Winit. This is a cross-platform window creation library. We will use this create to create a window that used to display our WGPU graphics. Another one is a poster here is a minimal async execution that lets you block on a future. Another one is CG Math. This is a linear algebra and mathematics library for computer graphics. We will use this to perform 3D transformations. Another important one is the image. Here, this is an imaging library that provides basic filter and decoder for the most common image format. So we will use it to create texture mapping. As mentioned previously, to run WGPU applications, you need to install a modern graphics card with a modern graphics API that is also called backend. Here we will use a WGPU function to check what kind of graphic cards and backends installed on your machine. Now open the min.rs file and replace this function here, the print hello world function to replace this code. Here we first create an instance by calling WGPU backends or functions. So this function returns all the backends installed on your machine. WGPU supports different backends. Here it shows some valid backend name. You can see first Vulkan and Metal, DirectX 12, DirectX 11, OpenGL, they call it GL. Another one is Browser WebGPU. This is supported when targeting the web through WebAssembly. Another one possible value is a primary. This primary contains all APIs that WGPU offers the first tier of support for. This including Vulkan, Metal, and DirectX 12 plus a browser WebGPU. This is a primary support, a first tier by the WGPU. And also possible value is secondary, or the APIs that WGPU offers second tier of support for. This including OpenGL and DirectX 11. And another one is OR the function. This retain OR backend, including primary plus secondary. So here you can see from this function we retain all the backends. Then we use a for loop here. We print out the adapter. So now save this file. Now we can run the application by pressing Control F5. There's no debugger. Okay, or using cargo, run the cargo command here in the terminal. The cargo run to run our application. Here the adapter information. In my case, I have four adapters. The first two actually is one adapter, AMD Radeon R9 200 series. This with the backend is working. And also the same AMD Radeon graphic card has a backend DirectX 12. So this AMD graphics card supports two backends. One is Vulkan, one is DirectX 12. And another one is default Intel HD graphics 4600 graphics card. This is integrated GPU here. This backend is DirectX 12. Another one is Microsoft Basic Render Driver. This is not a real graphics card because the device type you can see is CPU. It's a virtual GPU, a graphics card. If you don't have any graphics cards installed on your machine, they will use the CPU for your display. So this backend also DirectX 12. Here we want to use the powerful AMD Radeon graphics card. So we can choose the backend is working. So you can uniquely select AMD graphics card. But if you want to test the DirectX 12, the backend, the Intel graphics card will come first because Intel graphics card is integrated GPU. So it is default a graphic card to be used. So in order to use AMD graphic card with DirectX 12 backend, we need to change the default graphic card to AMD Radeon. Unfortunately, Windows 10 does not allow you to easily switch the default graphics card. One way to do this is to disable Intel graphics card. So now, from Device Manager, open Device Manager. Here, you obtain the display adapter. You can see we have two graphics cards. One is AMD Radeon, another Intel. Right click Intel graphic card. You can see disable devices. Click this disable device. So disable this device. Okay, click yes. Intel graphic card disabled. Oh, close this window. Now we run this again. Cargo run to see what happened. You can see this one doesn't count. So we only have one AMD graphics card with one with a working backend, one with DirectX 12 backend. So if you use DirectX 12, so that's a unique pick up the AMD graphics card. In this video series, we will use the VNet to open up windows that will be used to display our WGPU graphics object. Here we will create an empty window user VNet. Now we need to replace the content of this main.rs file. Before we can build a window, first we need to create an event loop. So use the event loop new function. The event loop is for any process that needs to interact with messages related to the user interactions, like a keyboard, mouse event, and so on. Once we have this event loop, we can create a window with window new function. Here we can set the title as my window. Inside event loop run the function, we have a control flow, a wait, which pauses the event loop if no events are available to process. Here we only check the window close request event. If window is closed, then we will exit the control loop here. So this here, the main function, will create empty window with the title my window. And you can also close the window by exit the control flow. So now we can save this file. Then we can run this application again. Cargo run. This brings up the empty window with the title is my window. Now we can close this window by click the close. So this close request will send to the control flow exit. So you can exit this program. Now I will end this video here. In next video, I will show you how to create a simple WGPU triangle and this development environment. See you next time. Bye.